You can't have jobs without companies. In our last video, we set everything to start using the Google Cloud Talent Solution Job Search API and started by creating a company. Now, let's dive deeper into creating and updating companies as well as checking out their properties. Here's the Python code we use to create the company. As you can see, it's pretty short, but let's quickly go through what we're doing since a lot of it will apply to the API as a whole. We'll be using version 3 of the API for all of our code. Don't forget to check out the documentation for any of the latest updates. Everything above this line is setting up the client library, but we're also setting a global variable with the format of projects, slash, and then the ID of your project. This is important because all the companies you deal with, and then later jobs, will have this project as the parent they belong to. It's also easy to see this when you look at the name of a created company, which we'll look at when we run the code. Inside our function, we'll set up the company to be created, which gets passed in, and make the actual request. The client library makes it clear that we're creating a company with projects.companies.create, and then we pass that project ID along with our company properties. This code also prints out the resulting company details. After some error checking in our function, we'll go back and set the required fields and call create company. Right now, we're only using two fields, display name and external ID. These are the only required fields for creating a company. The display name is exactly what it sounds like. It's the name that displays for the company. External ID is your identifier to help you track the company with whatever your job system has. You can put whatever reasonable string makes sense here, or just put the same thing as a display name if you don't have a current system identifier or if you're a staffing agency and don't want to reveal the hiring company's information. With just these, we'll create a company, so let's run the code. Here's a printout of the details of the company. We can see the fields we passed in, as well as the name of the company, which is generated on a create and serves as a unique identifier for this company in the Job Search API. We'll use this anytime we need to reference the company in the API, such as updating it or when we create jobs. You can see that it follows the same format from before, projects slash your project ID, slash companies slash, and then the unique company name. Great. We can now create companies and use their unique names as identifiers. Now let's go back and take a quick look at that list companies code from the previous video. Thanks to the client libraries, this code looks almost identical to the create code. Inside of our function, we'll do companies.list instead of companies.create, but still pass in the same project ID. Once we make the call, we'll just quickly check if there are any companies returned and list their display names along with their unique names. With this short snippet, we can quickly see what companies we've set up with the API. Let's run the code and see some output. Here's two companies I made earlier. Pretty straightforward, but what happens when you need to update a company? We'll do that by patching it. Here's our update code. Hopefully the structure looks pretty familiar. We'll be calling patch to update the company, and we'll pass along the unique name as well as a full company object with all the fields we want to update. The project ID isn't needed here because that's already included in the company name. Here's where we set the name and the fields in the updated company object, in this case, a new display name. It's important to note that you can't change the external ID or the automatically generated name for any company. When updating a company, you should include every property in the passed in object, even those that aren't going to be updated. Otherwise, any missing properties would get removed from the company. To avoid any confusion there, we actually recommend providing an update mask, where you specify only the fields you want to update. This is a string that you can pass in with a comma-separated list of fields that you want to update. Here's some modified code that shows setting an update mask to update the display name along with the size of the company. Size is an enum that we'll talk about in just a second. When we make this API request, only the fields explicitly listed in the update mask will actually be updated, and other fields will just be unchanged. Now, let's look at size and other properties of a company. The more information a company has, the better the experience will be for job seekers. As we just saw, size is an enum that you can set to represent the amount of people that work at the company. There's a few options here, and if you're using the Python client libraries, you can just pass in the string value. Here's some other properties you'll probably want to include. Headquarters address, which is the string address of the company's headquarters. The API will geolocate the address and try to fill in more specific details in a read-only property named derivedInfo. Jobs will have their own addresses. Hiring agency is a Boolean if this company posts jobs for other employers. EEO text is a string that lets you include an equal employment opportunity legal disclaimer for all of the jobs associated with this company. website URI is a string for the company's website, and career site URI is a string specifically for the company's career site. Image URI is a string for the company's logo. You can also delete companies if you don't need them anymore. The delete operation is pretty simple, and you just pass along the company's name to delete it, exactly as you might expect. It's important to note that a delete will fail if the company has any open jobs associated with it. Now that you can work with companies, let's start talking about jobs. Then again, we've covered a lot today, so let's talk about jobs in the next video. Check out the documentation if you're eager to get started, and let us know if you have any questions. Thanks for watching, and remember, when looking for talent, it's okay to keep your head in the cloud.